Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to teach you how to use a lookup field inside of a table in Microsoft Access. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. Last time, we created a contacts database with one table called contacts. If I double click on here, I can see that I created a flag over here denoting whether or not this contact is a personal contact or not. But what if you have more than two options? It's not just personal or impersonal. What if this is a work contact, a school contact, a family contact, etc.? How could I set up a field so that I force the same spelling of the word inside of this field every time so that I can do further data analysis on it? Well, first of all, I'm going to close out of here and I'm going to create a new table. If I go up here to create and I go to table design, I'm going to create a contact type and I'm going to make that short text. So if I right click here and I go to data sheet view, I'll be asked to save the table and I'm going to say yes. And let's just call this contact types. Notice I'm keeping the name of the table and also the name of the field over here as one word with no spaces. And I'm going to say okay. Then I'm going to be asked if I want to create a primary key. For now, I'm going to say no, and we'll talk about this in a minute. So let's just say my different contact types are work, school, family, friend, and let's just use that for now. But I want you to think about a couple things here. First of all, what if I decide later on I want to change friend to close friend and acquaintance, and all the ones I'd already marked as friend, I want to make close friend, and then I'm going to go forward and add some acquaintances. If I make this text my primary key, then I can't really change the spelling on this. However, if I go back to design view by right-clicking on here and going to design, if I right-click here when I have this right-facing black arrow and go to insert rows, up here I'm just going to type contact type ID and I'm going to make this an auto number. Save that. And right click and go back to data sheet view. And now I can see that every contact type is associated with an ID. So if I store this ID and then I change how I'm describing the contact type, the rest of my data will be updated to whatever the change in text is. So it's really a good idea to store the primary key over here instead of making the text that you type in your primary key, just because it's easier to plan for the future that way. So just keep that in mind. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So now that this contact types table exists and you can see my different contact types, I'm going to close this and right click on my contacts table and go to design view. So right here where the personal is a yes, no field, let's change this data type. So let's change this to text just for now. And if I save this by going up here to save, right click and go to data sheet view. Now I have the personal field here and it just retained the yes or no. But let's just say right here, this is family. And this is family, but I spelled it wrong. And this is work. While I think I filled this incorrectly, when I go to do data analysis on this, I'm going to see that FAMLY is a different category than FAMILY. So that's the reason I want to store a pointer back to this contact types table that I created, because that will stop me from misspelling my words right here. So if I right click here and go back to design view, let's change this instead of being freeform text. Let's change this to number. And the reason it's going to be a number is because if I open up the contact types table again, I want to store the ID, which is a number. If I right-click on here and go to Design View, I can see specifically it's an auto number. And down here, that auto number defaults to a long integer. So if I close out of here and I go back to Number, this is also a long integer. That data type needs to be exactly the same. But if I right-click here and go to Datasheet View, say Yes to Save, and I will be warned that some data may be lost. And my data will be lost because I want this to be a number and I had entered text in there before. So I'm just going to say yes. And I'm going to be told that I had errors while converting the data. That's fine. And I'm just going to say yes again here. So now when I go look in this personal field, I should have a number. It's defaulting to zero. And I don't have any data left in here. But let's turn this now into a lookup field. So I'm going to right click on here and go to Design. And I'm going to make sure Personal is selected here and go down here to Lookup. And see my display control? If I click in here, I get a down arrow and I can select combo box. A combo box is synonymous with a lookup field or a drop-down box, but combo box is the term that Access uses. So I'm going to select combo box. And right here, I can select from a table or a query. And if I click here, I can see that I also have options that I can hard code in values right here, but then I'll always have to be typing those values in later on. I kind of want to store those values inside of a table because it makes it a lot easier to go back and to be able to add to that table and to be able to add new contact types. But if you know for sure that you're only going to have a couple of different values in this and that list is never going to change, then you can select value list. Okay, so if I click in the row source, if I hit the drop down, I can select my contact types table. And then if I go up here to save and right click and go to datasheet view, now when I go over into this personal field, I can see the IDs from my table. Now the ID is what we're actually storing, but it's not really useful to the end user. So I'm going to right click back here and go to design view. And I have a property down here called column count. Let's change this to 2. And if I right click here and go to datasheet view, I must first save the table. Let's say yes. And if I go over here to personal and I click down, I can now see 1 is associated with work, 2 with school, 3 with family, 4 with friend. So if I select this, I'm going to get a 1 in my field right here. But let me show you something else that you can do that's a lot more user-friendly to reading your data. If I right-click on here and go back to design view, I have a column count of 2. And so if I open up my contacts table, this right here is column 1, and this right here is column 2. So I'm going to close that. So if I come down here to the column widths, if I make column 1 a 0, and I put in a comma, and I make column 2 about an inch. Now if I save this, and I right click and I go to datasheet view, when I come into here, I can only see what is in column 2, but actually my database is storing the value in column 1. It's actually storing that number, even though it looks like it's storing the text. So if I select work here, and I select school here, and I select family here, I can see those values, but there's really a number in this field. Now, one more thing I want you to notice. I misspelled school. I put 3 O's in there. And if I had 10 records of freeform text of how I misspelled school, I would have to go back and update all 10 of those records. But if I double click on contact types, this is the source where I'm pulling this data from. And because I'm storing the 2, watch this. If I correct my spelling of school and I click off that record so that it's saved and I go back to contacts, I can see that school has been changed here. That's because the ID is being stored as a pointer and not the actual text itself. So this concept is a little bit confusing, but if you would like to watch the video again or leave a question below, I'll try to explain it a little more in detail for you. If I right click and go to design view, this property right here called bound column See how that's one? That's saying that column one is the value that's actually being stored in this field. And column one, if I double click the contact types, is this first column right here, which is the ID. So I know from column one being the bound column, and also from looking at the data type being a number, I know that this field is being stored as a number, even though it looks like what's in the second column. And that's because I set the width for the first column right here to zero. So it's essentially invisible. And let me show you one more thing. If I double click on my contact types, let's add a new type here. Let's say this is someone I know through music. If I close this table and I right click here and go to data sheet view, I can now see that when I access my dropdown, music has been added as a category down here for how I know this person. So let me right click here and go back to design. So anytime I add something to my contact types list right here, the next time I run this table, it will be updated in whatever field I have put the combo box in, and there will be more and more values for your user to select from. And one final property I would like to show you. If you come down here to this property here that says limit to list, this is the property when set to yes that will force your user to have to pick something from the drop-down list. So if I right click here and go to data sheet view, if I come in here and I type in something that's not in the list and I try to click out of that cell, I'm going to get an error saying that the text you entered isn't an item in the list. And I'm essentially forcing the user to have to pick something that is in the list. And as you've seen before, that's good for controlling your spelling and making sure only legitimate options are picked in this list. If I need to get out of there and I don't want to add this record, see this little pencil right here? That means I'm still in edit mode. If I hit escape on my keyboard, that pencil goes away and that whole record goes away as well. So I'm going to right click here and go back to design. This isn't really a flag for personal anymore. That's not really capturing what data this field is storing. So instead of personal, I'm going to highlight that and change it to contact type. It's okay if this field name is the same as the other one in this table because they are in separate tables. So I'm going to save that. And now I have a new field called contact type instead of being called personal. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of how to set up a lookup field inside of a table in Microsoft Access. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.